the children, as we have done with the lesson adjectives in the last episode, that we have seen what is an adjective and types of adjective. We have completed with two types, that is three types, that is adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, adjectives of number. And as I told you, now here adjectives of number and adjectives of quality. If you see in both the sentences, I have written here, I have enough food, I have enough work for the day, I have read enough stories. Now if you see in both the sentences, one word I have used in common, that is enough. So sometimes what happens, this word enough or this adjective, we can use for both. For adjectives of quantity also, I can use for adjectives of quantity. Now, and I can use for adjectives of number also. I can use for adjectives of number also. So if you see the first sentence, it tells about adjectives of quantity. It tells about adjectives of quantity. Because if you ask the question, how much work I have for the day, I have enough work. And if you ask here, I have read enough stories. I have read enough stories. So if you ask how many stories, if you ask how many stories, you will be getting the adjectives of number. So but what happens, one word that is common for both, sometimes it may happen, we can use one adjective for both adjectives of quantity also and adjectives of number also. If you take one more example, that word, some words are like this or some adjectives are such that we use those adjectives even for quantity and even for number. If you take the other example, Meena wanted some money. Meena wanted some money. And second, if you take, some people want to meet you. You can see one word is common in both the sentences. Meena wanted some money, some people want to meet you. Now if you ask the question for the first sentence, Meena wanted some money. So if you ask the question here, that how much money Meena wanted, she wanted some money. How much? Here it is adjectives of quantity. Here it is adjective of quantity, we can say. But if you see, some people want to meet you, here also an adjective some. So here we can see some people want to meet you. How many people want to meet you? Some people. So this is about number. So from these sentences, I want to tell you that sometimes an adjective, it is common in both. We can use in both types, we can say, like adjectives of quantity also and in adjectives of number also. Sometimes what happens, one word or one adjective we can use for adjectives of quantity also and for adjectives of number also. Next we will be moving, let us learn about some adjectives of quantity and quantity which convey the same idea. It tells same idea. Some few words are like this, like little and few. If you learn about little and few, just don't get confused about this. Okay, little and few. See, both little and few convey the same idea. Both words, if you see little and few, these words, they convey same idea. How they convey same idea, you just see. But only the thing is what, but little is adjective of quantity and few is adjective of number. Previously what have we have seen, one word or one adjective is used for both, for quantity as well as for number. But here some adjectives are like that. Here we can see, those we can use only for the quantity. It want to tell the idea is the same only, but only the words are changed, and there some words are used as quantity and some words are used as number. but they both want to tell through their sentences the same ideas they want to express you in front of you. So, but little is an adjective of quantity and few we can use for the number. Little is used for uncountable noun. See, if you describe this, if you distinguish this, little and few, little and few. What is the first point we use for this little word? For quantity, and here we use for number. Here we use for number. Second thing is what? Little is used for uncountable nouns, where we can't count. They are used for uncountable nouns. But few we use for countable nouns. We use for countable nouns. Then see, a little, for example, we can say a little time, we can't count the time. Then a little work, work also we can't count. Okay, then here also we can see a few people or few chairs, where we can count the people, we can count the chairs also. Then this was about little and few. So this was the differentiation between little and few. First what we have seen in adjectives of quantity and adjectives of number, that what I have told about adjectives of quantity, that there we have to ask the question how much, and we will be getting the answer for that. Then in the third thing, what I have told for the third type, in adjectives of number, there if you ask the question how many, you will be getting the exact number. But if you see deeply here, sometimes what happens, some words are same and they are used for both adjectives of quantity as well as adjectives of number. Like one word I told you, some or enough, we have used for both. We have used for adjectives of quantity as well as we have used for adjectives of number. But exceptional some words, like adjectives like little and few, they convey the same idea. They want to tell you something in the same thing. They want to tell you same thing, but there are some exceptional things we can say. They are differentiated in two. Little word we used for only quantity, few adjective we use for quantity of number, adjective of number. Then little we use for uncountable nouns and few we use for countable nouns. The same thing we are going to see about much and money. Here also much and money, they also express the same idea. Much and many, much and many. If you take much and many, see, much same it is like little and few. Much we use for the quantity and many for the number. Then much we use for uncountable noun and many for the countable noun. Okay, see, these are the four things. Again, I will recall for you, see, all these things. See, types of adjectives, first we have seen was very easy, that was about adjectives of quality. There we are going to ask the question, what kind of? So, you will be getting what kind of a person, place, animal or thing is. But second thing we have seen, second type we have seen, adjectives of quantity. There we have to ask the question how much. If you ask the question how much, you will be getting the answer for adjectives of quantity. Third type we have seen, adjectives of number. There we are going to ask the question by using the words how many. Then if you will, you will be getting the exact number for adjectives of number. Then if you see, if you combine this both adjectives of quantity as well as adjectives of number, exceptional some things are there in that also. In this, we can find out one adjective is common, we can use for both adjectives of number as well as adjectives of quantity. For example, we can take enough. We have used that adjective for adjective of number as well as for adjective of quantity. Then if you move to the next part about little and few. Now, little and few, these are also the adjectives, they want to convey you the same idea. But the thing is what, they are differentiated into two rules we can say. for little we use little adjective we use for the quantity, and few we use for the number. And second thing is what, little adjective we use for uncountable nouns where we can't count, and few we can use for the countable noun. Same thing is with much and many. Much and many also is what it wants to express you the same idea, but the thing is what, much is used for the adjective of quantity, and little much many is used for adjective of number. Then much is used in uncountable noun and many is used in countable noun. So this was all about adjectives of quantity as well as adjectives of number. So if you turn the page, exercise D, fill in the blanks with the correct words they have given. See, for we can do with the two sentences. First one, if you see, for this you have to go through, in the bracket they have given two words, a few and a little. So here what you are going to write, for this you have to go through a little pain, where we can't count them, it is an uncountable noun, so a little pain. Second one, I want a little oil, this is oil also and it is an uncountable noun, so which adjective you are going to write there, a little. But if you see third one, I have 2- homework for today, much or many homework we can't count, isn't it, it is uncountable noun, so much, I have too much homework for today. Then we need -more hours to complete the work. Hours we can count 1 hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. So that is countable noun. So which adjective we are going to use? A few. And the last one, if you see, the baby is much happier now. Happy we can't count, this noun we can't count, abstract noun. So here we are going to use an adjective of quantity, that is much. The baby is much happier now. I hope children you have understood with adjectives of number and adjectives of quantity. Now if you move to the exercise C, underline the adjectives of quantity and circle the adjectives of number. Here you are going to underline adjectives of quantity and circle the adjectives of number. I will be taking two examples for you. First one, if you see, Manish goes to his art class 5 days a week. 5 days a week. And second sentence, many students were absent yesterday. So if you see the first sentence, what they have told you, to underline the adjectives of quantity and circle the adjectives of number. So if you see the first sentence, Manish goes to his art class 5 days a week. How many days he goes? Yes, he goes for 5 days. So this is an adjective of number. So what you are going to do here, for adjectives of number you are going to circle. Second one, many students were absent yesterday. This is adjective of this is, we can say, adjectives of quantity now. So how you are going to so if you ask a question, how many students were absent yesterday, so many students. I hope children have understood adjectives of quantity. See, adjectives of quantity here now, is it correct? Underline the adjectives of quantity, 5. Okay, now adjectives of number, this was adjectives of number and this was adjectives of quantity. Why here I have circled here, children? Because previously you have learnt that many students, much many you have learnt there. So many it comes in adjective of number. You have learnt before that along with little and few. How little is for uncountable noun and few is for countable noun. Same way much was for countable noun and many for uncountable noun and many for countable noun. So many students, so students we can count here. So many is also adjectives of number. Okay, so if you take fifth exercise, fifth sentence, please give me some water. Please give me some water. How much water? Some water. Or you are going to ask how many water? No. You will be asking how much water. So you are going to underline the adjective of quantity. I hope children have understood with this exercise 2. Now we will be moving to the next type, that is demonstrative adjectives. Now adjectives of number and adjectives of quantity, it is bit complicated, but you have to try to understand. Once again I will tell for you, adjectives of quantity is what? Adjectives of quantity, if you ask the question how much, you will be getting the adjective of quantity, and it is we can say it tells about the quantity of a thing only. It tells the quantity of a thing. But and you have, if you ask the question how much, you will be getting the answer. But adjectives of number, if you ask the question by using the words how many, it tells the exact number about the number of persons, the number of persons, animals or things. And in that also we can see something more about adjectives of number and adjectives of quantity is what. Here we can see one adjective, if you take for example some and enough, we use for both adjectives of quantity as well as for adjectives of number. But other thing is what, we can see adjectives of quantity like little and few. Little we use for adjectives of quantity and few for adjectives of number. And quantity in this adjectives of quantity in that little, as it is uncountable noun, we use there. And in adjectives of number we use a little, a few, by because it is a count where we can use for the countable noun. Much and many also same thing, much we use in adjectives of quantity and many for adjectives of number. Much in again for uncountable noun and many for countable noun. So don't get jumbled up, much, many and little, few. So that will be very easy when you go on solving the exercise. Next one, we will be moving to the fourth type of adjective, that is demonstrative adjective. Fourth type is demonstrative adjective. What is demonstrative adjectives? Okay. See, if I write one sentence like this, this bike is Rahul's. Then second, if I write, I can see that mango tree. I can see that mango tree. If you see both the sentences, the words this and that, they are adjectives. Since they describe, it tells about the bike. Here it tells about the mango tree. That's why they are adjectives. But the thing is what, here the word that points out, they are pointing to the other noun. They are pointing to the noun. Now this is pointing to the bike, that is pointing to the mango tree. And these are the adjectives, these are the demonstrative adjectives. What is demonstrative adjective? It points out, when it points out to the noun, that is called as demonstrative adjectives. When they point out to any noun, that is called as demonstrative adjectives. And there are four, that is this, that, these and those. This and that for singular nouns, and that, these and those for the plural nouns. Two things you remember, this and that, they are this and that or these and those. These are the demonstrative adjectives which we use in the sentences to point out the nouns, and that's why they are called as demonstrative adjective. Now, this and that we use in singular noun, and these and those we use for the plural nouns. I hope children you have understood with this. And if you want to ask the question, if you want to get an answer for demonstrative adjective, you are going to use these words. Which one? Which one? If you ask this question, you will be getting the answer for demonstrative adjective. How? Which one is Rahul's bike? This bike. Which mango tree I can see? That mango tree. Which mango tree I can see? That mango tree. If you ask the question by using these words, which one, you will be getting the answer for your demonstrative adjective, and it is very easy. This, that, these, those. If you see on page number 35, they have told, see, this and these are used to point out persons or things which are near. They are sometimes this thing is also there, which is very near, this book, or we can say these books which are very near. And that and those are used to point out persons which are far away. That tree or those buildings, they are far away from us. And also the thing is what, that and this are used for singular nouns, and these are those are used for plural nouns. So these two things you have to remember. Okay, now if you see page number 35, underline the demonstrative adjectives. Who, first one, if you see, if you take the first sentence, who gave you this book? So which is the demonstrative adjective is here? Yes, it is this. Then such a fantastic match it was. Such is a what we can say, such is also demonstrative adjective, such. Then Komal lives in that house, which is demonstrative adjective over here, that. Then those boys are my friends. Here also we can see those, because here you can see those boys. Now those boys, suppose those boys are far away and they are in plural, so we can use those word here. I have seen that movie. Now movie, you see it from far away, and that, because it is a singular noun. Then such kids are loved by all. Suppose such is one exceptional word. Sometimes in grammar we have some words exceptional, very few times we use those words. Those are exceptional, and even they, we count them in the grammar also. So such kids are loved by all, such. And last one, if you see, did you join that school? That school, it is maybe far away and it is singular noun, so that. So I hope children you have completed with the exercise F. Now if you see G exercise, rewrite the following sentences by changing the words printed in bold to plural forms. You are going, now here if you see, one example I will give you. You are going to change those bold words into plural. They are in singular, you are going to change it into plural. Rohan wants that pen. Wants that pen. Now this that pen, I want to change, it is singular, it is a singular noun. I want to change it into plural. How I am going to write? You are going to rewrite the sentence again. If you write again, Rohan wants, what is the plural form of that? Those. Those. Now you are going to write the noun also in a plural form. Those pens. Those pens. So you underline this word, these words, so that you can understand that you have changed it into plural form. If you take the second one, such a beautiful picture. Now here if you see beautiful, it is describing the picture. It is an adjective. You can't make it plural. Adjectives we can't make it plural. Only you can change the noun. Okay. Now what here it is? Such a beautiful pictures. Such a beautiful picture it is. So you are going to make it plural now. If you write like this, if you want to make it plural, how you are going to write? Such a, you are going to remove out now. Such beautiful pictures. Such beautiful pictures. So you have turned it into plural. I hope you have understood with this exercise that how you are going to make it, how you are going to turn it into plural forms. Next, if you see, the sentences will be given in plural forms, you are going to turn it into singular one now. I want those bangles. I want those bangles. It is in plural form. You are going to turn it into singular form. I want those bangles. I want those bangles. If you see these words, those bangles, they are in plural form. You want to change it into singular. So how you are going to write? I want, instead of those, that. Bangles, bangle. I want that bangle. I want that bangle. So this is plural form. And now you are going to change it into singular means that will be those will be that and bangles will be bangle. Second sentence if you take, I loved those flowers. I loved those flowers in the garden. Here if you see the plural form, that is those flowers. This you are going to turn it into singular. How you are going to write it? I loved, instead of those, that. And instead of flowers, you are going to write flower. I love that flower in the garden. So this way you are going to change into singular to plural form and plural to singular form. And if you take I exercise, fill in the blanks with the correct options. Now this, that, these, those they have given. You have to change it into, you are going to write the correct option. Dash garden is so lovely. So garden is a singular noun. So this garden, this garden. Second, dash boys study in my class. Now boys, they are plural and they suppose they are far away. So those boys study in my class. Pia has brought dash bag with her. So bag is a singular noun. This bag. Dash diamonds are very expensive, those and that. So diamonds are plural. Those diamonds are very expensive. And last, if you take, who brought dash packets? Packets are also plural. So these packets, who brought these packets? So we have done with the exercise I, and that was all about demonstrative adjectives. So we will be moving to the next types in the next episode. I hope children have understood all these types of adjectives. Thank you.